My name is John Peter Gahan, and I designed a rotary two-stroke engine for motorcycle Grand Prix racing many years ago, but the authorities banned two strokes because of pollution. However, I believe this engine is still viable as an economical and cheaply produced engine in modern day use. So the whole point is that most two-stroke engines use a separate crankcase for the cylinder, but this engine uses one crankcase for four cylinders. The other two cylinders are not on here because otherwise you wouldn't be able to see these tracks, the blue and yellow tracks, the inlet, the transfer, and the red one is the exhaust tract. So as the engine rotates, the functions of the induction and compression are drawn out through the ports and tracks lining up as the engine goes round. Now if we consider the bottom cylinder, this piston is just about to come from the base of the stroke, and it draws the gas in through the inlet port, both inlet ports here, and it then compresses it into the transfer track. Now there's no chance that the compressed transfer gas can go back into the inlet because this port is the same width as this blank part here, so that the inlet track is closed before the transfer track is open. It then compresses the gas into the transfer track all the way around here until it reaches this point where it is brought outwards to this outer port. It then is then transferred when this port opens into the upper cylinder and is then compressed until it is ignited. And there is a spring here with a contact, and the length of this spring allows for the advance and retard required for the different operating speeds of the engine. The piston then goes down under power, and the exhaust port is opened at the time when the port lines up with the exhaust tract, and that is the cycle of the engine. The crankshaft is geared to the crankcase so that it's always in time, and the piston always reaches top dead center at the same place. Whichever cylinder is here, it always reaches top dead center at this point. However, I say top dead center, which is not exactly correct, because the piston doesn't come to a dead stop. Because it's a rotary engine, the piston doesn't move in a straight line. Well, it does in the cylinder, but in actual fact, it goes around in a circle. So it never actually stops like a normal piston, which means that the front conrod is under much less stress than the traditional conrod. And because the conrod is in circular cross-section, the lower cylinder has a seal around here to seal this part from the crankcase. This allows the crankshaft to be lubricated in the normal four-stroke fashion, which avoids the pollution of the gas being polluted by the oil. Also, as explained previously, the transfer charge doesn't go down the exhaust port as a traditional two-stroke. So the main two problems with the two-stroke have been overcome. And because it is such a lightweight, compact design, it is ideally suited for the motorcycle. But it can be used in any like a light aircraft or any location where a normal engine is used, but it will not work on diesel. It cannot be used as a diesel principle, but it can be used in any other way whatsoever. So that is the workings and the understanding of my rotary two-stroke engine. Thank you.